If you Bing for .NET 6 admin panel, your options are Coravel Pro, done by this very nice chap called James Hickey, but this is commercial. Your other options are, well, not a lot, which is very strange considering this is Microsoft's flagship web development framework. If you're using Laravel Nova, you get this nice admin panel built by the creators of Laravel. If you're using Django, you get the Django admin site, which is this nice admin site built by the creators of Django. But for .NET 6 and .NET Core, you don't get a lot. Let me tell you about my solution. So here we have the Contoso University sample, updated for .NET 6. We have it in a folder here. Let's go ahead and open this in Visual Studio. So far, so good. We will flip over to Contoso University and run it. We will run it. We should see the Contoso University sample come up. So far, so good. This is a database-backed project where you can do all this CRUD stuff. But this CRUD stuff could be seriously improved with our admin panel. So here is our .NET 6 minimal API. So this might be a little bit unfamiliar to you if you've just done .NET 5, but this is brand spanking new. However, core admin does work with it. The first thing we need to do is go and add the NuGet package. So over here on the right, we'll right click on references to add NuGet package. We can search for core admin like so. And here we are. We can install it. Yes, yes. Very nice. Back to our program.cs. And then under builder services, we can just go builder.services core admin. Now we can do one more extra cool thing, which is also change the URL that the admin panel is accessible on. So if we go at the bottom, app.use core admin custom URL, I can go my super admin panel, like so. Save. Let's run the app. And here we have the Contoso University sample. If we go my super admin panel, we have the core admin panel. So this has automatically detected all of the entity framework DB contexts and so on, and all of your models, and has given you a nice snazzy set of CRUD screens with dates and all sorts. So validation, sorting, searching, that sort of thing. So see, very nice. Courses, you can create them and so on. There you go. For full documentation, head over to the GitHub page where you can read it all here. And this shows you how to set it up. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to click the star button up here and maybe like and subscribe to the video if this was useful. Cheers. Until next time.